We can't ignore the injustice of targeting the Catholic Church.
Milwaukee's new archbishop pulls no punches at the state capitol as he fights a bill he says takes aim at the Catholic Church. Now at 5, why bill supporters say the church should be held responsible for sex abuse claims. Good evening, I'm Toya Washington.
And I'm Terry Sater in for Kathy. Archbishop Jerome Listecki says changing Wisconsin's law could be detrimental to the church.
12 News' Kent Wainscott is just back from Madison. And Kent, the bill would remove the time limit for sex abuse victims to come forward.
Yeah, it would lift those time limits for civil cases, lawsuits, but not for criminal charges. And some say it could resurrect decades-old cases of child sexual abuse. And the debate has the new leader of Milwaukee's Catholic Church at odds with Milwaukee's top law enforcement officer.
Archbishop Jerome Listecki put himself front and center in this debate involving child sexual abuse. And he began his testimony with an apology for the past actions of some priests.
I apologize to the victims, survivors, and their families for the harm that has been caused.
But the Archbishop opposes a bill that would temporarily lift the statute of limitations on old abuse cases, opening the church up to the possibility of lawsuits he suggests could run the risk of bankrupting the archdiocese.
This bill will have the effect of doing something that everyone will go out of their way to tell you they don't want it to do. That is targeting the Catholic Church.
On the other side of the debate is Milwaukee County's district attorney, who supports the bill, calling it a fundamental issue of fairness to victims.
The process should be open for those individuals that have suffered from abuse to seek redress, to seek justice in the proper form. And that's what this bill would allow them to do.
I was sleeping and he would come and abuse me.
Perhaps the day's most compelling testimony came through an interpreter from three men who say they were abused by a priest decades ago while students at a local Catholic school for the deaf.
It took me such a long time before I could do anything about what had happened to me. And I want to be in support of this bill, 319, because I am a victim. And there are many victims out there who need to have a chance to be able to get some justice.
Now, some of the discussion today focused on the actions of the Catholic Church under now-retired Archbishop Rembert Weakland. Coming up at 6, we'll hear the new Archbishop's blunt assessment of Weakland's leadership and what the author of this legislation has to say about the Archbishop's claim that the bill targets the Catholic Church. Toya.
All right, thank you, Kent. And members of the Survivors Network for Those Abused by Priests, or SNAP, are also addressing the issue of child sexual abuse. The group is thanking District Attorney John Chisholm and urging Archbishop Listecki to reconsider his stance on the statute of limitations.
Why we have to change the laws in this state that Archbishop Weakland actually helped to create, which are predator-friendly laws that...
Members of SNAP say they've requested to meet with Archbishop Listecki 5 times over the past year, and those requests have not been answered. The Archbishop and Isley did speak to each other briefly during today's hearing.